Hey everybody, welcome back to the Sinking City. Alright, got comments this morning. Let's see. Volpez, formerly Danny Lowe. I was sure that Granny would live in a gingerbread house. Not quite. She's a witch, but she's not quite like Hansel and Gretel style witch. She's very much an evil old hag, though. I guess if you had your sanity drop low enough, that'd be kind of interesting to have it look like you were in a gingerbread house or some shit, but, you know, that'd be kind of okay. And from Iggy91, fuck, I wasn't ready for that teddy bear. Gotta remember not to eat anything while watching this playthrough. I'm sorry, I did mention that this was some disturbing shit coming up, you know, grim, dark fucking stuff. I think from now on, anything I know of for certain that's going to be, like gross or kind of horrific like that, I'll have to put like both the text and audio warning in it, because, you know, sorry about that, but I will state that that is, I believe, the only time in this whole game that it actually gets like that. You know, I will say that that is one of the most darkest fucking things I've ever seen in a game in like forever, honestly. And some guy says, please take this really sharp object as a sign of friendship. Wow, just wow. Yeah, well, you know. Some people give, like, flowers. Some people give fruitcakes. Some people give fucking alcohol. Other people give knives. Hey, you know, what can you say? And, lol, to hunt for more XP. Fucking A, motherfucker. XPs, man. We gotta get those XPs. Well, anyway, guys, thanks for your comments, and on with the show. Okay, we're gonna go rescue this guy's fucking family real quick. Excuse me. Alrighty. What's our route? Okay, yeah, hang a left. Ah, okay, there we go. Yeah, I didn't bother loading up anything, so whatever ammo I got is whatever ammo I got. Oh, look. Obviously, there's no way to go through anything. I'm in a dead end, right? Wrong. All right, fuckface.
Hi there, Billy. Gotta say, I liked you more last time we met.
Same to you, pal. Heard you might be coming, but hoped you wouldn't. So how about this? Leave now, and I pretend you weren't here.
Why did you need the buyers anyway? What do you get out of it?
There are powerful entities in this Borg. You should know better than to question their affairs. So you best get out while I'm asking politely, Charlie boy.
Billy, holding a family hostage doesn't suit you. Let them go, and we both walk out in one piece.
It's not gonna work out that way. There's a reason the buyers are here. When the time comes, we'll set them free.
Now remember, this is the guy that rescued you from the ocean shore and took you to the hospital. It would be nice, you know, if he would, like, surrender, but he's not going to. So, guess what? He gets a smoke.
Sorry, Billy. This is bigger than both of us. May the best man win.
So this is how it ends, eh? I hoped you might be different. It's a shame you'll die here, Reed. This city has far worse men than you.
No. Oh, shit. Out of ammo. Sorry, Billy. Yeah, I gotta heal. When all else fails, run downstairs like a fucking chicken and hide. Okay, that's two down, three down. Alright, cool. Mow them all down. No, it's one, two, three, four, five down. Okay. I thought my spray and pray was a little less effective, but guess it worked out, excuse me, pretty damn good. I gotta admit, I'm annoyed by the reloading sequence on this, though. The Thompson submachine gun fires from an open bolt. What that means is the little handle on top behind the sights. When you load it, you yank the drum out, stick a new drum in, and you pull the handle back, and it stays back. When you pull the trigger, that handle flies forward because it's actually on top of the bolt, and it strips around out of the drum, stuffs it in the chamber, and fires it because it's got a little nub on the end of it that hits the primer and sets it off. This is how it can actually stay cool and, you know, not melt down, basically. Because guns that fire from an open bolt don't overheat so badly. But in this case, you see him pushing it back forward, and it doesn't work like that. There's no hammer on the fucking trigger group to actually hit a firing pin. It's literally just a fucking big block of steel with a little nubbin on it that slam fires it. Anyway. Agreed by EOD. Barry Morgan, fisherman, disturbed by Innsmouthers catching all the fish. Luther Merritt, daughter raped and killed, guilt of EOD members unproven. Wallace Rose, injured in a fight with Innsmouthers. George Cavendish, name circled in red. Wife joined EOD, bore a child that wasn't his. Kenny Harvey, saw Innsmouthers stealing from him. Delaney Jensen, son disappeared in shells, blames Innsmouthers. Sketchy notes of feckin' mother's young. Things to be told to Graham of their intellectual abilities, similar to those of a three-year-old child, but will continue to evolve mentally. Will perform simple orders immediately after brought to life. Understanding of complex sentences will come later. Of nutrition, though expendable, they are living beings and require chemicals to sustain optimal level of functioning. Give potassium and cod liver oil. It's good for their tissues. Will ask for sugar. Do not give. General care. Do not expose to direct sunlight right after birth. Their fibers are not yet firm and may decompose easily. A map and an accompanying piece of paper with written coordinates. 479 South, 126, 43 West. Steps to return spirits of the long dead ones of corporeal life. Essential salts. Copy the formulae from the Borealis Grimoire. Per Adonai invocation. Should be recited for several hours. Search for exact wording through the works of Peter D'Apano. D's, me's, just shit, invocation, maybe the great invocation of Agrippa. Ye Nash Yog Sothoth invocation, written in different handwriting. Ye Nash Yog Sothoth, he Igib, Igib, Throdag. Combine together and present a hill, crossed out. Just give him the books and hints. Let him find everything on his own. Hey, fuck off, demon, go away. No, I'm kidding.
What the hell? Everything I've faced since coming to this city is on this map.
I got it, Bailey. We'll make sure no one from the expedition gets back to shore. And if anyone slips through, I've got just the guy to handle it. Goes by the name of Lewis Flynn. Very obedient, will do everything he is told to, providing with detailed instructions. A note that smells of fish. Mr. Drunion, your proposal proved too tempting to resist. I will tell the police whatever you need, though in return I will require some assistance on my election campaign. So see, yeah, there's a whole fucking conspiracy going on right behind your back. I think that is everything. I'm taking a look at the guide because I don't want to miss any stuff there. Aw, does that hurt?
Oh, thank you, mister. I thought they'd kill us. I don't know how we can ever repay you. Who are you? You look...
I'm a private eye, and your father's worried about you two.
Father? Is he okay? Did you see him?
He's fine, but this isn't over yet. Do you have somewhere you could hide out for a while?
Yeah, sure. We'll stay at Aunt Peg's. What's going on?
Your father and I have a matter we need to deal with together. He'll explain everything when he can.
Okay. Please, mister. Take care of him. He's a good man.
I'll try. I've got to go.
Have you come to save us?
Yeah, y'all can walk like right the fuck out of here if you want. All evidence. There we go. Sorry, Billy. Shouldn't have fucked with me. Okay, well, now what we're going to do... damn. Mm. What we're going to do is we are going to... There we go, Agatha Pierce. We're going to go to Agatha's house. And where did it say it was? Lives on Beacon Street near the corner of Bullock Street in northern Old Grove. So... Beacon and Bullock. There's Beacon and Bullock. So that's our point right there. Alrighty then. Trudge, motherfucking trudge. Can I have the map now, please? That looks so much like a fucking freeze. I believe we found the right fucking spot anyway.
Agatha Pierce, I presume? The name's Charles Reed. I'm a PI.
Good day, young man. What's your business?
There's a matter that I'd like to discuss. It concerns your son, Milton.
Oh no. What's happened? Is he okay?
I'm afraid this may take some time to explain. Perhaps you have something to, wet my whistle.
Oh, fear not. I keep my cellar stocked for just such occasions. Would you kindly fetch us some Chianti from the cellar? You look more than capable.
Ma'am, that's a most generous offer. So why do I sense a quid pro quo?
Oh, no. Well, I did hear something rustling around. But I'm sure it's nothing you can't handle.
Leave it to me.
Here are the keys. Pick any bottle, as long as it's Chianti. And don't shy away from the good stuff. It's there to be shared with guests like yourself.
Milton sent me here to kill you.
Milton? No, it can't be. Please, Mr. Reed, you must have it wrong.
Look, it's the truth. He wanted his inheritance and needed your death to look natural. Poison was his solution.
No! I don't believe you! Please go away! I feel sick. Oh.
Alright, all evidence collected. Alright, so we just screwed him over with his mom. I believe I've done this right. If I've done this right, then the fucking politician's gonna get it. Okay, where'd this fucker live at? Glenn Byers, right? Yeah. Alright, so we need... Yeah, that's the right spot. There are several autosaves for this, so if I do botch it, I can reload and go back and try it again. You know, in a different way. Whatever, people are getting beat up. I don't really care. I'm trying to save the world, not just one or two people. Just in case.
Your family is safe now.
Yes, thank you so much. My sister-in-law just called to say Evelyn and Michael got there safely. I owe you everything. What happens now? Should I turn myself in?
First things first. You need to write a confession. It's your word against the witness.
Okay, I'll take it over to the police station immediately.
No, just give it to me. And the murder weapon. You still have it, right?
Yes, sir. Here's everything.
Good man. I'll go clear things up. I suggest you make the most of your time before the coppers come knocking. I'll get going.
Milton Pierce tried to frame me, so I'm returning the favor. If I plant the gun among his bloody clothes and take a picture, Mr. Carpenter should consider it sufficient evidence against him. Fucking A right. Fuck that guy. I'm not a fan of politicians. I think Congress should have like a Wheel of Misfortune where we like, once it per term, we like string one of the fuckers up. Unless you like they enter a lottery, right? Unless they're like a freshman, you know, their first term, then they're exempt. But anyone who's repeating their terms, yeah, they they can fucking get it. Excuse me. Why are you sweeping the fucking streets, dumbass?
He's completely mad.
I'm not the asshole sweeping the fucking street. I'm just the asshole hitting people with shovels. See, like this.
Help me, please.
Excuse me.
What's your problem?
You're in my fucking way. That's what my problem is. Oh, yeah. Downstairs. Fuck me running. Ah, what the hell. Oh, he's not down? There we go. I hate those fucking smokers. Yeah, I'm gonna have to farm for some shit here, cause I am like completely out of like everything. Everything good. There we go. Evidence against Pierce. Well, hi guys. I'm not exactly interested in fucking with you. I think the experience scale is kind of skewed because these guys are worth 20 XPs if you pop them. You know, it takes one round. These guys take like four rounds. They should be worth at least a little bit more, I would think. Am I going the wrong way? No, I'm going the wrong way. Fuck. Excuse me.
Hey, knock it off. What's your problem?
I'd crank a few rounds off and get them all to run the fuck out of my way, but that would get the cops shooting at me. Don't really want to get shot. Don't want to waste health supplies. Actually, I could heal, to think of it. Yep, time to craft some more. Alright, yeah, I got like nothing, so. But I'm not gonna farm on camera because, you know, you guys have seen it. It's pretty boring. We're going to go to Carpenter's house and we're gonna turn this dumb motherfucker in.
Proof that it was Milton Pierce that killed Johannes Vanderberg.
Show me what you've got.
The murder weapon is in his house, and a pile of bloody clothes. Here's a photograph.
I don't know how you managed to pull this off, Reed, but it's impressive work. We'll take it from here. Accusing a mayoral candidate of murder is an interesting challenge, but the Carpenter family has tackled worse.
Yep, and we have a tear right outside the gate.
You've been doing a great job, Mr. Reed. I'm waiting for you at the Devil's Reef Hotel.
All right, well, we're going to go there, and we're going to get We'll deal with this. The guy who's ostensibly murdered just invited me to the fucking hotel, so what the hell does that tell you? There's more than meets the eye to that fucking dude, let me tell you.
I'm watching you, newcomer.
Yeah, you can shut your fucking cock holster.
How? How is this possible?
At last, Mr. Reed. I heard about your recent case. Let me congratulate you. You've truly outdone yourself this time. A question, if I may.
I've got a question. How on earth are you still alive?
What can I say? Perhaps next time you should make sure you finished the job.
It wasn't me, and you know it. All this. All I went through, and there was no murder to begin with.
The prosecution would beg to differ. They had all they needed. A victim, a method, and a culprit. The rest is just bells and whistles.
You set me up. You son of a...
I only set the scene.
I'll...
What? Kill me? As amusing as it would be to see you charged with my murder a second time, I'm afraid we have more pressing matters.
What do you mean?
You know exactly what I mean, Mr. Reed. The prophecy. The seal. You have made yourself a part of something momentous. Now, to your latest case. Wonderful execution all round. And I mean that literally. The hanging has been scheduled for next week. Tell me, Mr. Reed, why did you do it? Why condemn a man of such high station for a crime he did not commit?
He falsely testified against me and tried to blackmail me. Someone does that to me, there will be consequences.
Fucking so you took matters into your own hands. Bravo. A conscious choice. With a violent end. But who am I to judge? Regardless, I shall call this experiment a success. In fact, you should consider it a taste of your ultimate trial.
I don't understand. What do you get from all this?
You are headed into the darkness, Mr. Reed. I'm giving you the experience you'll need to find your way through it.
What do you mean, my ultimate trial? What does this have to do with anything?
Of course. Everything. It's your destiny. Destiny beyond comprehension. To be more than a speck of cosmic dust. To make waves across the universe. To end things.
And what?
Everything. You've suffered in this city from the very beginning. From the moment you were born, in fact. Wanting to end it is only natural. But unlike those untold millions before you, you have the power to do so. You can turn mere prophecy into absolute truth.
You don't mean...
The seal of Kotiganar is in your hands. You possess the key to the gates and all they hold within. You can close them and cling to mankind's misery for a few more cruel centuries. Or you can open them and end it. And you will do the latter.
Why? Why would I destroy everything?
Because otherwise your life amounts to nothing. Do you know how many chosen few there have been over the centuries? Nameless hordes, sacrificed at the whim of invisible masters. Not unlike those who watered the poppies of Flanders with their blood.
But our sacrifices mattered. We won the war.
A war, with many yet to come. This is your kin's nature, your purpose. To suffer. Your monkeys in an open cage, unwilling to walk out. Only you can make a difference. You can end it all for good.
So what the fuck is he? Obviously he's not human.
You're wrong. I'll prove it.
You will prove nothing. You'll die. And at the next turn of the cycle, another will come along who is brave enough to finish the job. Nevertheless, I cannot abandon you, whether you agree with me or not. Your path is too important, even if your choice is beyond my control.
You're right about one thing, at least.
There is an archaeologist in this city. He is very close to unraveling the secret of Kategonar. And you'll need his help to get inside. His name is Joseph Hill. Here's his address. Talk to him. Earn his favor.
Seriously? All that, and you don't even know how to find Kategonar?
If I knew that, would I be working with a private eye?
This is wrong, Johannes. All of it. And I still have no idea why I should even believe you.
The truth is the truth. Whether you believe it or not, you can accept it, or try to put the blindfold back on. It doesn't matter. Farewell, Charles. Whether we speak again or not, I will be watching. And don't lose the seal again, or all your effort in this city would go to waste.
Yeah. You can eat a dick, pal. So we've unlocked a whole bunch of different stuff. That's his, of course, his stuff there. Oh yeah, I need to actually finish that up. I can go with that, but nah. Canning Factory Mysteries. Blackwood Marsh Canning Factory was last night the site of some sad and unusual events. According to neighbors, inhuman screams and shouts in an unknown language could be heard for several blocks. Witnesses also reported seeing flashes of light in an unnatural color they struggled to describe. Ebernote Blackwood, the final representative of the Blackwood grand family, was later found dead inside the factory. The cause of death could not be established, but with it comes the end of one of the pillars of Oakmont society. Harriet Doe missing. Well-known scientist Harriet Doe has gone missing. The professor of archaeology at Oakmont University has not been seen for days, and friends and colleagues suspect the worst. My men searched the entire city, confesses Oakmont Police Captain Caleb Lyons. Sadly, we have every reason to assume that she is no longer among the living. With any information regarding the whereabouts of Professor Harriet Doe, is kindly requested to contact the police or the Oakmont Chronicle office. There we go. Shitload of experience. Yeah, we want some better shotgun damage. That 10% chance on the battle rifle is kind of almost not worth it. I mean, I will get that eventually because there's still plenty of I can wear fucking fuckface's costume. Yeah, let's do some shit for Throgmorton. Lives on Goldbridge Road in Central Oak Grove. Between Windhalf and Sentry. Yeah, fuck it. We'll just go there. This is a really interesting case. Yeah, I'll just go this way. Whoa, what the hell was that?
The door won't budge.
Okay, is that the right fucking place? Because, Okay, well, weird. Maybe that's not the right place. This is not the usual way for me to come at this. Oh, good, because I wanted more fucking monsters in my life. Is he upstairs or is he downstairs? Ah, shit! No, bad monster. Bad monster. Bad touch. I don't know you, this is my first. Oh. Alright, fucker. Need any healing. Got a statue head. Always wanted one of those, right? No further loot to be had down. Oh, well, antipsychotics. There ain't enough of those in the fucking world, man. Oh. This room is about. Well, what the fuck ever. Yes, this. Well, he's dead. I can loot his fucking house.
Eyes still wide open. Guess he didn't see the killing blow coming. What's that?
Mirrors everywhere?
Looks like they're short a full set. One of the mirrors was taken. Yeah, you like what you see, buddy? Huh. That's a lot of warning shots. Only slight scratches around the keyhole. Whoever broke in knew how to pick a lock.
We got the tear. Yeah, I don't see any other evidence.
Squint, run! Oh, okay. Killed him!
Easiest gig in this district. You grab the mirror. I'm gonna go see what other loot we can take from Mr. Moneybags here.
Who are you? What in K's name are you doing in my house?
Okay, let's see what we have here.
Easiest gig in this district.
Who are you? What in K's name are you?
Squint, run! Okay, I've killed him.
Two men broke in to steal a mirror. One of them, Squint, cracked the safe. But Glover discovered him and shot him. Second one killed Glover.
Okay, so I missed something, damn it. What am I missing? Is there something over here? No. We got that. Yes, I'm XP whoring. Damn it. The XPs are so good. Oh. I'll be right back.
I'll find out why the old ape wants you so bad.
Mr. Throgmorton, it is with the deepest regret that I must inform you that the price for the piece you've requested has changed once again. The demand for it has increased, and now it is triple that which we agreed earlier. I know this is the second time I've raised the price, but the extreme circumstances of the flood make each piece almost invaluable to me as I cannot replenish my collection. Herbert Glover. Okay.
Keep a 40-year-old newspaper article.
Francis Throgmorton, the city's darling scholar and adventurer, is once again an eligible bachelor. Further text unreadable. There we go. That's everything. Throgo's daddy is now, or was, once again, and as they call it, an eligible bachelor. And I'm going the wrong fucking way. Awesome sauce.
What's your problem?
Okay, so we're going to the cop shop.
What's your problem?
Here we go. Squint's police file. Philip O'Connell, alias Squint, sex male, age 46. Residence unknown. Crimes, numerous burglaries in Old Grove, breaking and entering, tax evasion. Possible associates. Name Sidney Stokes, alias Nunn, sex male, age 21. Residence, Oakmont, Massachusetts, northern Salvation Harbor, west of the intersection of Moreland Road and Salvation Road. Crimes, jaywalking, lollygagging, jury duty dodging. Hey, I'm guilty of that last one. Yeah, I've only been to jury duty like once ever, and that was after they like put a warrant out for my ass, so I fucking finally had to go. All right, so anyway, west of the intersection of Moreland Road and Salvation Road, okay? Okay, there's Salvation Road. Excuse me, Moreland and Salvation. Yeah, fuck. Okay, I think that's right. Fucking hell. All right, that should be good. Oh, shit, sorry, I didn't get a whole lot of sleep, so I'm like a little bit punchy. Good, and I'm like damn near out of ammo. So we are good to go. And I absolutely need to fucking reload. As soon as I get done recording, I'm gonna have to like go and farm some fucking stuff because I am out.
Looks like Squint was having a bad day. Survived getting shot just to be stabbed to death. But who did it?
At long last, I'll fix what that old ape lover Francis did to you.
Fuck! Get away from the... Oh, thank the gods. I thought you were another monster.
Sydney Stokes, I presume.
Aye, that's right. Do I know you?
Don't think so. I'm here about Herbert Glover. I believe you know him. Or, should I say, knew him.
Okay.
Nice trick with the wall. How'd you manage it?
It wasn't me. She put the wall there with some kind of hocus-pocus.
You said she put the wall here. Who is she?
She's our employer. I don't know her name or anything. She promised us a good payout for a simple job. And I fell for it like a chump.
What did she hire you to do?
The job seemed simple enough. Go to the collector's house, grab some fancy mirror, and then hoof it out of there.
So where's this fancy mirror now?
She took it. When me and Phil met her with the goods, they got into a big blowout and she shivved him. Okay, what am I to do now? Phil was the idea guy. I'm just a sap.
Were you hired to kill the collector too? Or was that just for laughs?
I swear to Kay, it wasn't part of the plan. It was an accident. The guy started shooting at us and I panicked.
You panicked? Really? That's your excuse.
Oh, please, as Kay is my witness, I didn't mean to kill anyone. I'll give you everything I have. Just let me walk.
Look, you might be a sap, but at least you're an honest sap. I'll look the other way, but you better get scarce and fast.
Oh, thank you. You're a lifesaver. You won't see me again, I swear. Here, take this. Thanks again.
Okay.
Oh, Ma. I killed him. What have I done? What in the world have I done?
I want to be able to run, so I'm going to turn off the weirdo vision. Letter from the morgue. Mr. Stokes, the price for a separate burial for your mother, Martha Stokes, is 30 bullets. The morgue cannot give you a discount. There are more requests for burials than we have resources or manpower to satisfy. You must make the payment in 2 weeks, or we will have to inter your mother in a mass grave.
I'm happy to say I've never been hungry enough to consider eating whatever this is. Rest in peace.
There we go. Everything. Yeah, I'm going to go to Thrago and let him know what's up. And I think we're going to call that an episode right there. Because this is kind of a long quest here. And of course, I can farm some more ammunition, considering I'm damn near, like, out of it. I guess I can start hucking explosives and Molotovs and shit at people, but, you know, I try not to, because that shit tends to be more to whom it may concern rather than, you know, explicit.
I've looked into your delicate matter.
Excellent. Don't spare me any details.
Glover's dead. He was killed by a man named Sidney Stokes who happened to be robbing his place. And he wasn't working alone. He had a partner, Phil O'Connell. Didn't end up much better. All over some kind of mirror, apparently.
Truck. Where is a mirror now?
Their employer has it. Some mystery woman. I didn't get her name, but she obviously wasn't fooling around.
I see. So, my enigmatic competitor has finally shown her hand. And the thieves are both dead, you say?
Their employer decided to bump them off. Now, I hope that's not standard business practice in these parts.
You've proven to be far more valuable to me alive than dead, Mr. Reed. You have nothing to worry about in that regard.
All right. I've held up my end of the bargain. Now, it's your turn.
Of course, Mr. Reed. Here's your payment. Now that you know everything, would you accept the second part of the job?
Let me guess. You want me to track down the mirror?
Yes. And the one who so rudely snatched it from my grasp.
I'm on it. Only got one lead, though. Our culprit had a bone to pick with someone named Francis. Mean anything to you?
Ah, yes. That is, without doubt, my father. Francis Throgmorton. Kay rest his soul.
What's he got to do with this?
I found mention of the mirror in his records. That's what led me to take interest.
Your father was a prominent man.
I'm sure he had enemies. Anyone come to mind?
None who would outlive him.
You mentioned your father left records. Mind if I take a gander at them?
The prospect of you rifling through my father's possessions does not fill me with joy, Mr. Reed. But if that's what you need, so be it. Take this key.
Alright guys, that's it for today. With that, next time obviously we will be completing this investigation, and you're going to see some of the more, well, grimmer shit in this game. Depending on how you do this quest. I'm going to do it the more grim way. It's more fucked up and more interesting, I think. So anyway, guys, with that, I will see you next time.